shape pictures is created internally to hang on the walls of our imagination. Faith pictures is created internally to hang on the walls of our imagination. Your faith pictures is a gift from God that unlocks your faith to achieve your purpose and destiny. It is crucial that you see the right picture and avoid wrong photographs of failures, defeat, and discouragement. Let me give you three life-changing principles and keys about faith pictures. Number one, whatever you can see, you can have. Whatever you can see, you can have. Just to back up a little bit so you can follow me. The scripture setting is not talking about a natural sight. It is talking about sight through your mental capacity, which is a spiritual sight. So let me say it one more time. Whatever you can see, you can pursue. Mental pictures determine focus. Mental pictures determine focus. Focus determines your behavior. Focus determines your behavior. The picture that dominates your mind will control your behavior. The picture that dominates your mind will control your behavior. Hence the reason why they will not understand you when you are going somewhere. People that are going somewhere is mostly misunderstood because of their behavior based on where they at. Where you at, people believe that you must behave the way you're supposed to behave because of where you at. But even though you are in a situation, you behave with a different behavior, and it puzzles people to understand that you are laughing when you're supposed to be crying. Because not because I am in the thing, I must look like the thing. One of the greatest skills and ability that you can always be blessed with is the ability to go through hell but not look like the hell that you have been through. So your behavior pattern will puzzle everybody. It will puzzle people that are trying to pull you down, because the more they pull you down is the more you give God your praise. When you think that you should have done give up and throw in the towel, you are still in church. You are still on your knees. You are still talking positive in spite of all the lies they told on you. Can I get a witness without me talking to anybody here? Why is it that your behavior pattern is different than how it's supposed to be, or what they are expecting? Is because your focus is in the right place. When your focus is in the right place, it doesn't matter what's going on presently. What matters is what's going to happen, not what's happening right now. Your focus is not where you are, but your focus is from where you are into something you are going to. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody that is happy, not because of anything that is happening presently, but because of what's going to happen after a while? Is there anybody rejoicing, not because of what they're facing, but what God has already prepared for them? You might not have it right now, but it doesn't mean that you're going to die without it. You might not see it right now, but if you keep your focus, I'm prophesying to somebody. If you keep your focus, what you see, you can pursue. My possibility is not in my educational background. My possibility is not by because of my financial backup. My possibility is not because of where I work and who I know or who knows me. My possibility is in my focus. If I can watch it harder, if I can meditate what the Bible says, he said, meditate upon it. If you want it, meditate upon it day and night. Tell yourself, I don't have it, but I can have it. Tell yourself, I'm not driving it, but I can. I can. I can. Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. Whatever you can see, you can pursue. Sit in the night and you visualize it. I like it to say like this, picturize it. And you picturize it hard. It seems like everything is against your vision. Because you wake up in the morning and seeing stuff that can discourage you. You see stuff that can cripple you and paralyze you. But if you only close your eyes in spite of what is all around you and see it hard, see it and believe it, you can pursue it. It means if you see it, you have to get up and hunt for it. If you see it, you have to catch it. If you see it, you have to push for it. Is anybody can see it? Yeah, you might have the money to bring it to pass, but if you can see it, you can push, you can pursue. And if you try a little bit harder, you can catch, praise God. What the devil's trying to rob you off, you can take it back. Yes, yes. Oh, yes, yes, yes. So the picture that dominates your mind, it has to dominate your mind. The picture that dominates your mind control your behavior. You're smiling and they wonder why. It's because there's something that is dominating my mind. I know I'm supposed to think all kind of stuff right now, but there's a greater power than poverty. There's a greater power than in discouragement. Every time I try to worry about my future, up comes the picture that dominates my mind. Every time I try to say I'll never make it because I tried before, up came a picture that has dominated my mind. You ever go to sleep with something and wake up with the same thing and go to work but it's on your mind, come home it's on your mind? Well, that thing is going to change your life. It's either negative or positive. I'm trying to develop some pictures that can dominate my mind. Pictures that tells me that all things are possible. If I can believe it, I can have it. If I can speak it, I can receive it. Somebody say hallelujah. The picture that dominates your mind controls your behavior. So you're walking and leaping and praising God. You're going to work skipping and smiling. And right behind you in the next desk, somebody's trying to criticize you. They're talking about you. But every now and then, you're lifting your hand and saying hallelujah anyhow. Because there's a picture that that is dominating my mind, and the thing that dominates my mind is controlling my behavior. It's not my fault. Why? I'm shouting so loud. There is a focus that is dominating my behavior. Somebody say hallelujah. There's a focus. There's a picture that is controlling my mind. And I try to shut up, but I can't shut up, because whatever is dominating my mind is controlling my behavior. I'm not responsible for shouting so loud. I'm not responsible for singing my song. There's a picture that is dominating my mind and controlling my behavior. Someone say hallelujah. Is there anything on your mind that is controlling your behavior? Sit down. I can't sit down. Shut up. I can't shut up, because there's something on my mind that I'm visualizing that is controlling my behavior. Crying, but the picture is controlling my behavior. I'm laughing, I'm jumping, I'm walking around my house saying no weapon that is formed against me. Why are you saying that, Bishop? Because there's a picture that is controlling my behavior. To give up, I just get started, because I'm being controlled by my vision. I've been controlled by my desire. Sit down, please. Sit, please. Write this down quickly. Sight gives birth to desire. Sight gives birth to desire. What you see is what you pursue. Have you ever been suddenly motivated to go to the refrigerator and eat after seeing a television commercial on food? Pictures affects behavior.
Number two,
God can give you pictures of events in your future. In verse 16 out of chapter 13, it said, "And I will make your descendants as the dust of the earth, so that if a man can number the dust of the earth, then your descendants will be numbered." God gave Abraham a faith picture of his children.
Y'all need to hear this.
God can give you pictures of events in your future. Where he was standing. Where he was standing. God showed him hundreds and hundreds of years before he even got there. And he showed him a faith picture. Let me tell you a little bit more about faith pictures. It's nothing that you can see with your natural eyes. It is not the ordinary, but you have to see it as though it's there. You have to believe that it's there. And that's what he told Abram. He said, I'll bless your seeds like the dust of the earth. Listen, the reason why we have so much crazy families and so much wayward children is because we never create them in our mental capacity before they become in the natural. Everything that's going to happen in the natural, baby, you must first create it in the spiritual, or you're going to be messed up with it. Write this, please. Write this, please. Your future is the manifestation of the picture you imagine. Write that, please. Whatever you're going to receive in your future, you have to first imagine the thing. Last week I told you the act of, but in a better, in a more greater definition, it is the action instead of the act. The action of forming new ideas. The word imagination. The action, taking action in forming new ideas. You have to have imagination. Because your future is the manifestation of the imagination. I say it one more time. Whatever manifests in your life, it must manifest based on faith pictures. Imagination. Watch this now. Number three. And then I'll close. Hey. Number three. Write this, please. God will not always give you a picture of attack ahead. This is very important to embrace. That God will not give you, or will not always give you, a picture of attacks ahead. Have you ever reached a place in your life? Surprise in someone that you used to trust. I need to talk to you here this morning. I need to talk to you. Is there anybody in life ever turn on you? And you tell yourself, if I had only knew this person, I would have never put so much trust. Talk to me, I'm going to talk to you here this morning. It's very important to know. There was a time when Elijah made this miracle, and this woman that could not have children, suddenly by prayer, the miraculous power of God, she became pregnant and have a son. Y'all remember when Elijah was on the hill and that woman came crying and calling Elijah? And then Elijah saw the woman at the bottom of the hill, pastors. And when he saw the woman at the bottom of the hill, he didn't know what happened. You see, the reason why she was crying is because the son that Elijah helped her, prayed for her to get the miracle to have the son, by the time he got to 12 years old, he was dead.